Max Cynader was born in a refugee camp in Berlin, Germany.
You know, my parents' lives were destroyed by World War II, and I was at that point, the only child. And as a kid, I was basically told I could be a doctor, lawyer, or engineer. Those were kind of my choices. I started at McGill University when I was 16. I really loved learning about how the brain worked.
He has made major contributions in the areas of neuroplasticity, how the brain recovers from insults, and in terms of processing sensory information, in particular in the visual system and in the hearing auditory system.
Max's major contribution has been in neuroplasticity and brain development. It seems simple today because everyone agreed that the brain is plastic, but when he started, that was not the case. Many people were doubting that really we could induce and study plasticity in the brain.
People viewed the brain as kind of fixed, so that if damage was done to the brain, there was no opportunity for recovery. I think Max's work has shown that that is categorically not true.
And when children have a neurodevelopmental problem, it can lead to disease such as schizophrenia, autism, hyperactivity. That's the type of disease we think about a lot.
I've actually been quite interested in figuring out ways in which you could advance that research forward to the benefit of the patients.
I was able to translate these findings into clinical practice and basically reverse the deficit that you see under certain conditions in kids that suffer from vision problem or auditory problem. Of course, that had a major impact worldwide for these kids and their family.
From a very early stage, he's been very successful in translating scientific discoveries into commercial applicability.
I had an epiphany one day and I realized that you could recast the problem of vision and stereopsis into a way of thinking about how the two ears processed information. We thought we were going to develop a hearing aid. We eventually discovered the killer app, so to speak. It turns out to be in cars. And at one point, our technology was in 20% of the world's cars. More recently, my research interests have floated in the general direction of brain diseases that tend to affect older people. And we now have protein-protein interaction blockers that are tremendously effective in stroke. They can actually save about 90% of the brain cells that would otherwise die following stroke. We're working on other blockers of protein-protein interactions. We have something that looks very promising in neurotrauma, something else that looks very promising in frontotemporal dementia. And, you know, I think the sky's really the limit for this kind of technology. Armed with the strength of all of these wonderful scientists, we've been able to build this fabulous new facility, which brings together neurology, psychiatry, geriatric medicine, rehabilitation sciences, and of course we've got a brain bank, a DNA bank. The dream of this facility is to blur the distinction between advanced care, clinical research, and fundamental research.
It's impossible to overestimate the importance of the vision that he's had.
The pace of discovery is continuing to accelerate. So if we can come up with first better understanding, then better diagnostics, and then treatments for these diseases, and I believe we can, we're going to have a massive impact on the health of our population.
A world-renowned neuroscientist, outstanding visionary, and gifted leader, ladies and gentlemen, Canadian Medical Hall of Fame laureate, Dr. Max Cynader.